بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In the previous video we discussed two asbab, two means that can result in the increasing of our wealth and that could result in having blessed mubarak rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So watch that video for the first two and today we'll discuss number 3, 4, and 5. The third means is salah, prayer. Allah in the Quran he says وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا لا نسألك رزقا والعاقبة للتقوى. O Prophet of Allah, command your family to pray salah. وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا and stay steadfast upon it. لا نسألك رزقا. Sufyan Thawri Rahimahullah says this means لا نكلفك الطلب. We don't ask you to worry about it, to worry about your risk. We're not asking you to be responsible for your sustenance. نحن نرزقك. We will sustain you. So Ibn Kathir mentions under this ayah how Allah put rizq and salah together. That wastabir alayya, just keep praying, times look tough, but just keep on praying, Allah would open the doors. إِذَا أَصَابَهُ خَصَاصَ When the Prophet ﷺ would face any type of hunger or poverty in his family, he would come to the doors of his homes and he would say, Ya ahla, ya ahla, oh my family, sallu, 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 pray salah, pray salah, pray salah. إِذَا حَزَبَهُ أَمْرٌ فَزِعَ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ Whenever a really important matter came to him, he would rush towards the salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in hadith al-Qudsi, he says, Ya abdi tafarrag li ibadati. Oh my servant, take out time for my ibadah, worship me. أَمْلَ صَدْرُكَ غِنًا وَأَسَدُّ فَقْرَقْ وَإِلَّا تَفْعَلْ مَلَأْتُ يَدَكَ شُغْلًا وَلَمْ أَسَدُّ فَقْرَقْ He says, oh my servant, take out time for my ibadah, worship me. If you do this, I will make you wealthy. I'll expand your chest. You will never need money. You will never feel poor or feel in need. وَأَسُدُّ فَقْرَقْ And I will close all the doors of poverty for you. So you don't have to worry about if all the doors, all the employers and jobs are, you're losing all the jobs and opportunities. As long as you're taking out time for me, I'll take care of you. وَإِلَّا تَفَعَلْ And if you don't do that, مَلَأْتُ يَدَكَ شُغْلًا I'll make you really busy. So busy. This is the key. This is the most misunderstood concept ignored in our country. In our country and in the whole world. Busy. Everyone's busy. This is sort of a punishment from Allah. مَلَأْتُ يَدَكَ شُغْلًا You'll be so busy. وَلَمْ أَسُدُّ فَقْرَقْ But in spite of you being so busy where you don't have time for your own family, your spouse, your children, your parents, you don't have time to even eat food properly without looking at your phone. In spite of that, you will still be in need. Your needs will never end. Your ends will never meet. So this concept of making our children, our families, a home that is establishing five times salah is marzuq. Marzuq means is being blessed with rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A facility or a manufacturing plant or a business that everyone in there that has to pray salah is praying on time and not just praying quickly but praying as if their entire life depends on this salah. Like my entire life depends on me correcting this salat of mine, then this business, this household is marzuq from Allah. This is a good time to just press the reset button and say, you know what? Let me put the five times prayer schedule in my house. Make sure my entire family prays. We pray with adhan. We all pray salat together. And we redevelop this habit of ours. So the third sabab is to learn how to take from the treasures of Allah by resorting to salah. The fourth sabab is another very important aspect that sometimes we start missing in our lives, and it is صلات الرحم, joining ties with our family members. من أراد أن يبسط له في رزقه وأن يؤسى له في عمره فليصل رحمه. The Prophet ﷺ he says, anyone who wishes to see an increase in their wealth and leave a good legacy behind, then they should join ties with their family members. Many times with our day-to-day busy schedule, we miss out on the greatest wealth that we have, which is our home, our wife, our husband, our children, our parents. Their days go by. We didn't really capture a smile of our child because we were so busy. We couldn't even sit with them for a few minutes, running 9-to-5 jobs from business. We're staying there all day. And maybe this was a reset button we actually need in our lives to spend time with our parents, spend time with our family. A blind man was asked, if God gave you your eyesight back, what would you ask for if you only got it back for 1 minute? And he said, if God gave me my eyesight back for 1 minute, I would only look at my child and his innocent smile, because when I had this eyesight, I never valued it. I never paid attention to it. But there's children who are sitting in front of us and we're on our phones because we bring work to home and we go from home to work. It becomes a very difficult lifestyle to maintain. And because of that, what happens is we become a different person, not even realizing the number one reason for, you know, relationships going downhill is a lack of discourse. We stop even having, our communication ends. Like, we cannot have meaningful conversations with our spouses because our head is somewhere else. We're thinking about different things. And because of that, unknowingly, it starts unknowingly. We don't even realize we're changing. And we don't even notice that our loved one is reacting in the way she or he is reacting because we're so occupied with our work. I think this is a great time to reestablish these relationships, invest in these relationships. Oh, my dear friend who is a young man or woman who's listening to this video and watching this, if your parents are alive, fall on their feet, take care of them, feed them, vacuum the house, clean the dishes, do their khidmah, because it is in your khidmah, the service to your parents, that Allah will increase your wealth. Maybe this is the time you need it off, because usually our excuse and we get a pass is because we're going to college, you know, 12 credits a semester, we're probably doing a job as well to make ends meet, we're probably driving Uber, doing different things, and we'd never have time for our parents. But now we're, you know, it all came to a pause. Universities are closed, we're at home. Take advantage of this time so that we get used to it, we reinvest in a relationship, that our father actually becomes our best friend again. And we are excited to go home and not looking for excuses to stay outside of our house. So this is the fourth way, fourth means of getting directly from the treasures of Allah, is to establish our family ties and invest in that. And if we do, Allah will increase our wealth and Allah will bless our wealth. The fifth means of taking from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one of the most powerful ones of them all. Like, this one touches me the most, even though all of them are important and the one should not be prioritized over the other. But this catches me off guard every time I read this. We have seen or probably experienced us crying out of regret over our sins. Like, if you committed a big sin and you go to the Kaaba, you start crying, asking Allah for forgiveness. So we might have experienced it or seen it. We might have experienced or seen losing family members and crying. We've seen people crying, shedding tears if they lost a family member or someone got sick in their family. But one thing we've hardly or rarely ever experienced in our lives is tears of gratitude. Like, a person is so overwhelmed with gratitude that he or she starts to cry. Oh Allah, you gave me so much, I don't deserve this, and I don't know what I did, and I just starts to cry and cry. And we're thinking, wow, does that actually happen? How is that even possible? And here's the Prophet ﷺ. We know that the Prophet ﷺ never ate, you know, two meals in one day. And if he ate one day, he would never eat the next day. His food, he would have food the third day. We know what a simple lifestyle he lived. He didn't have a lot of means. But in spite of that, he was such a person that would wake up in the middle of the night and cry so much every single night that Aisha radhiallahu anha would see the floor wet of tears and see his beard wet of tears. And she would have mercy on him, and out of mercy for him, she would say, Ya Rasulullah, why are you crying so much? Allah has forgiven all your sins, past and future sins. Why are you crying so much? And the words he would say, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Should I not be a grateful servant to Allah that He's given me all this? These tears are tears of gratitude. Being grateful to a point where he just couldn't control his tears. Yes, maybe we have lost our job. Yes, maybe we got laid off. But there's other risk in our lives that we have we should be grateful for. If we have children who are healthy, we should be grateful for that, because that's also risk. If we have eyes that we can see with, this is also risk. We should be grateful for that. How many millions of people don't have eyesight? If we have ears that we could hear this message with, we should be grateful for this. If we have legs and feet and hands, that we can, limbs of our body that are functional, and we don't have sickness, we should be grateful to that. If we have parents that are alive, this is all risk. If we have a house to live in, I can go on and on. Look at the other risk of Allah. Don't just look at money and wealth as a risk, but everything, وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. All of what we have that we're enjoying is a risk from Allah. So if we're grateful for this risk, Allah will give us that as well. Because the effect of gratitude is only increase. So if we're grateful to a point, even in the time of need, where we can cry, then Allah will definitely definitely increase our risk. Allah will definitely bless our families and our wealth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who can benefit from these messages that we're hearing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who can reach Ramadan and benefit immensely from Ramadan and make this Ramadan the best Ramadan of our life, even though it might be difficult and challenging, but Allah can do it. Jazakallahu khair. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.